Hola, SAP developers. The TOEFEST 2023 is around the corner now. This year, it goes from the 18th of September to the 13th of October. Similar to last year, we have 5 different tracks, and each track is assigned a day of the week across the 4 weeks. You can easily identify the sessions for each track by the color coding. Monday is dedicated to ABAP and CAP. Tuesday is for SAP Build and No-Code. Wednesday is all about integration. Thursdays, data analytics and AI. And finally, Friday, we have front end and also some fun activities. As you can see, there is something for everyone to learn during the TOEFEST. So make sure to check out the sessions available in the TOEFEST events page at groups.community.sap.com. RSVP to the sessions you're interested in attending. Download the calendar invite from the event page so you don't miss the session. Last, but certainly not least, same as last year, there is a contest in place and a grand prize. I'm including links to all the relevant pages in the description below. Happy learning.
I'm here in Berlin. You can see beyond me the Brandenburg Gate, and beyond that, you might be able to see the Space Needle here in Berlin. I'm here for the Builders Beyond Code event. Everything you wanted to know about SAP Build. We had Sebastian Schrotel talk about SAP Build, what it's about, why it's here, what you can do with it. I then spoke about the technical aspects. What are these products? How do you use them? What kinds of things you can build? Then we had a panel discussion that talked about no-code and low-code issues and how no-code and low-code is being implemented within the SAP landscape. And finally, the dozens of people who attended locally took part in a workshop where they built their own apps, processes, and business sites. This is a good time to remind you that we put on a SAP Build Code Jam, and we can do that all over the world. So if you're interested in hosting, go to the Code Jam page, reply, tell us when you'd like to host it, where you'd like to host it, and what topics you'd like to include. I'll leave a link in the description. And finally, I want to announce that there's a new learning journey related to SAP Build, specifically about how to integrate it with S/4HANA Cloud, how to bring data into your apps and processes, as well as how to update S/4HANA Cloud from those apps and processes. I'll leave a link to that in the description.
Are you ready to explore technology innovations and unlock your company's full business potential? SAP Business Technology Platform is built to unleash digital innovation across all your business functions. Join me this November at SAP TechEd in the SAP Business Technology Platform track. SAP BTP brings together data and analytics, artificial intelligence, application development, automation, and integration in one unified environment optimized for SAP applications. Whether you're a developer, engineer, technologist, or simply interested in the future of intelligent technologies, we have sessions to challenge your knowledge and build your expertise. Ready to take your business to the next level? Join me at SAP TechEd. Register today and I'll see you in November.
In last week's news episode, this month's developer challenge, Full Stack Development with SAP Cloud Application Programming and SAP Fiori Elements, was introduced. We are now in September and the challenge has already been launched. By the end of the month, we will have learned how to create a full stack application using SAP Cloud Application Programming and SAP Fiori Elements. We will base our full stack application on the domain of tests or exams like in a school setup. Being the final developer challenge this year, it will require extra effort and time compared to the previous developer challenges. It will require putting into practice concepts gained from the previous developer challenges and researching a little more to complete the weekly tasks. For this week's task, we begin with project setup and database modeling. This task will provide a foundation for the upcoming week's tasks. Watch out for our blog post to be released next week explaining the second week's task. The link to the challenge can be found in the details below.